Hello friends, today we are going to perform an experiment to determine the value of Planck constant using LED. So to conduct this experiment, first we need a breadboard, a regulated power supply, a DC voltmeter, a DC ammeter, one 220 ohm resistance, one red, yellow, green and blue color LED and some connecting wires. And here is the circuit which we want to make to perform this experiment. So, in the beginning, we will connect the positive of our power supply with a horizontal line on the breadboard. And after that, we will connect the negative of power supply with another horizontal line on our breadboard. After connecting the regulated power supply, you can also notice that the power supply has been highlighted in the circuit. So in this way, whatever portion we will connect on the breadboard, that portion will be highlighted on this circuit so that you can keep track of our circuit simultaneously. So after that, we place this 220 ohm resistor on our breadboard. So here we place it, and after that we are going to place our LED on this breadboard. But before inserting our red LED on the breadboard, we should know about the sides of a light emitting diode. So generally, you will observe that in case of an LED, the leg which is longer in length is P and the leg which is shorter in length is the N side of this light emitting diode. But in some cases, you will find that the leg with the bend is the P and the straight leg is the N side of the LED. So we can open its leg and place it on the breadboard. So now we can see that the P side of light emitting diode is connecting with the resistor. You can also verify this in the circuit diagram. After that, we can connect the positive of our power supply with one end of the resistor, which is ultimately connecting to the P side of the light emitting diode. After that, we will connect the N side to the DC ammeter. For completing this loop, we can connect the other end of the DC ammeter with the negative of the power supply. So in this way, we have completed one part of our circuit. Now we can also observe that the voltmeter is in parallel to the light emitting diode. So we can connect the P side of the voltmeter with the P and N side of the voltmeter with the N of the light emitting diode. So in this way, we complete our circuit. Now we switch on the power supply. Now we can measure the voltage across our light emitting diode and the current passing through this circuit. So in this way, we can make a table of it. So we will increase the voltage in our regulated power supply and will observe the voltage across the LED and current passing through this in milliampere. Similarly, we will repeat this reading for the yellow LED, similarly for the green and for the blue LED. So in this way, we have observed the voltage current reading for four different color LEDs. Now we will plot their voltage and current characteristics in a graph. So we will find that first there is a red LED, then this one is yellow, then here is a green and then the blue one. So these are the readings we observed in this experiment. After that, we will extrapolate the increasing current portion of this red LED, and the point it will cut on the voltage axis is called as startup voltage for red LED. We will do the same practice for the yellow, green and blue LEDs. Then again, we are making a table of it in which we have red, yellow, green and blue LED and we have their wavelengths. In this experiment, we are not going to find out their wavelengths, but their standard values should be given with the specifications of these LEDs. So we will take those values directly. After that, we will calculate the reciprocal of our wavelength in the units of meter inverse, and along with that, in the last column, we will write startup voltage. Now we will make a plot between 1 by lambda and the knee voltage, and we will find that This is making a straight line. Now we need to find out its slope. So to find its slope, we will draw two perpendicular lines AB and BC, and the slope of this line will be AB by BC. As we know, light emitting diode is a diode in which V0 is the minimum voltage required to light an LED. So when we apply a potential V0 across its terminal, so an electron contains the energy of EV0. When electron jumps from conduction to valence band, it emits out a photon of energy h nu. So in this way we can equate them. If we modify this equation a little bit, in which we are writing frequency to c by lambda, so we get this formula. And if we compare this equation with the equation of straight line, like y is equal to mx, in that case we can understand that the slope will be hc by e, and from this we can get the value of Planck constant, which is slope into e by c. So by using this formula, we can insert the value of slope in this formula and find out the value of Planck constant. So in this way we will get a value of Planck constant, but we also know its standard value, so we can also calculate our percentage error in this experiment. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to like and share to my video, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Have a good day.